In Barcelona, the two losing semi-finalists got bronze medals. However, if we did that, we'd be denied what I'm sure is going to be an absolutely fantastic match. These two players, different stages of their career. Lin Yun-Ju, only 19 years of age, and what a player he is. And he has this backhand banana shot that he plays with his backhand from the forehand side of the table, and he's played it absolutely superbly. Interestingly enough, the three Olympics I attended as a coach, nobody used that technique. It's a new technique, and he's one of the masters of it, and I'm sure we'll see him tonight play that to great effect. Ovtcharov, 32 years of age, has a wonderful career, world number one back in 2018, capable of beating anybody on his day, so it's going to be a close one.
It's funny you should say that, because a little anecdote. Liu Guoliang, one of the most respected men in the game, the president of CTTA, while watching Dima's match with Ma Long, said he had a stroke nearly. And what he yelled is a big surprise. I'll tell you right after this countdown. And here he comes, the silent assassin, the pride of Taiwan, Lin Yun-Ju, representing the Chinese Taipei team with his banana flick receive, shuts down third ball's attack, third ball attacks left and right. He's so aggressive over the table, so smooth in the rallies, and recently was making more noise than we had heard from him, the not-so-silent assassin, the slightly audible assassin.
Dimitrij Ovtcharov.
So here he is, 32 years of age, currently ranked at number 10 in the world, seeded number 7 here. He is a former world number 1 back in 2018. 2017 he had an incredible season. Won the German, Bulgarian, Chinese, Indian tournaments. And in 2019 he was the European Games winner.
And here's our official for the match, Mark Beckman of Denmark. So one side red, one side white, the coin toss. This is to determine who serves and where the players stand. So Lin Yun-Ju chooses the left side. Didn't see what Dima chose, but by the time the match comes around, we will know who is serving first. So what was the mysterious thing that was said? Ma Long, just for context, again, these semifinals were breathtaking. Ma Long was 18-0, had never lost a match to Dima in his life throughout his career. Dima only one time taking him to Game 7. And in Game 7, Liu Guoliang shouted from the crowd, "He can't beat you." He said, "He cannot beat you." And that is a very confident, bold, and authoritative statement. And he didn't say it like it's not allowed. He said it like it's not possible. And then after the match, you saw the celebration from Ma Long. He looked like he had won the Olympics at that point. And the first thing he shouted to Liu Guoliang is, "He can't beat me." 19-0, Ma Long might never drop a match to one of the greatest players of the last two decades in his entire career, despite 19 attempts. How's that for confidence in your player?
And it's probably how Ma Long responded so well. You know, he knew he's the boss, the president had confidence in him. He wanted to show the president that he was absolutely right to have that confidence in him.
So these two here, you saw them with their coaches in the corner. Jiang Penglong, the former top player in Taiwan from the Chinese Taipei team, was quite strong in his day, top few in the world. Dimitri Ovtcharov's coach, Jorg Roskopf, what's he doing right now? It looked like he was rolling out his rubber, making sure that it's flatly glued onto the blade. For those of you newer to table tennis, more casual ping pong players, first of all, we're very happy to have you here. You're watching this magical sport, and we'll be sure to tell you all about it. Professional players use very spinny rubber. Spin is everything at this level. And they freshly glue on new sheets to make sure that they're tacky enough and there's good traction. Anton Schellberg, Gustavo Tsuboi, Darko Jorgic, These are some of the players that the Silent Assassin quietly took down along the way. Now, Darko Jorgic had an incredible tournament, beating Liam Pitchford, one of the top threats to the Chinese team, and also Tomokazu Harimoto, one of the favorites for a bronze medal, to get to this match here.
And there we see Ovtcharov's matches so far. And that semi-final, 4-3, 11-9 in the deciding game. He's had a great tournament, but of course, he won the bronze medal in London. Can he do it again here? Or is Lin Yun-Ju going to win his first individual medal? He's won a medal already. He got a bronze medal in the mixed doubles. And here he is again, fighting for a medal. I do like the name Silent Assassin because I think it sums him up so well. Very unassuming, almost shy in the way he moves around the table, the way he conducts himself. Wonderful touch. And for someone not bulky in size, generates tremendous power whilst having wonderful touch as well. We'll see him delicately return the ball, then explode with power. And that backhand shot from the forehand side of the table, the banana backhand as it's been called. Jorg Roscoff there sat in the corner. Great player himself, European champion, world champion in doubles with Fetzner, Stefan Fetzner. That was in Germany in front of their own crowd in 89, I believe.
I confirm that. And 92 and 96 took some Olympic medals, so knows the grand stage quite well. What you're about to witness here is a best of seven match. That means the first player to win four games wins the match. Each game played to 11 points, must win by two. And it looks like Dima will start with the serve. Ball machine keeping it real for the players. Nice and efficient. Some TT technology. TTT. Love all.
First shot played by Lin Yun-Ju was that reverse backhand.
I felt like the placement, though, of the serve did keep it less effective than it has been for Lin Yun-Ju.
Both the serves there from Ovtcharov were to the middle of the table. One was short, one was long and fast, but it's 2-0 in favour of the German player. Lin now with his two serves to come.
Good follow-up. The third ball attack inside the table, not an easy ball, but he saw it lifting up just a little bit and was quick to move in.
Good deception on the serve. Ovtcharov thought there was backspin. He came under it. There wasn't the backspin. It popped up. Trademark shot there from Lin Yun-Ju, but this time, surprisingly, he missed that banana backhand. But again, it's clever play from Ovtcharov. He's playing more to the middle than he is into the backhand.
Little fun fact, these two have played six times before, and their head-to-head record is favored 4-2 by the Silent Assassin, who's only 19 years old. So 13 years younger, they've played over the last several years, and he's been quite effective.
That was into the backhand, the service, and as if on cue, Lin Yun-Ju, straight round, we'll see it on the replay. There he is, and this time, backhand on the diagonal, deep into Ovtcharov's backhand.
So with the first towel break, you've seen the Chiquita, the banana flick, and how effective it can be. The towel break will come up every 6 points, not mandatory, just optional for the players to make sure they don't stall too much.
See, there was a classic example of that ability to touch the ball. He was going to topspin. He readjusted there with that backhand push. It was an incredible shot. He committed himself to attack, counter-attack, adjusted, delicate touch shot, and then wins with aggressive topspin.
Now, yesterday when we saw the Silent Assassin play, we talked a lot about how bold and how brave his serves were. Most players don't serve long nearly as often as he does, but he's so good at disguising the placement of his serve that it makes it very tough for the receiver. Good catch. Kudos, but nothing for the scoreboard. Okay. Ooh, dribbler off the top of the net. It's not so common we see Dima do these sort of simple serves from the backhand. None of his iconic spinny serves.
That was an amazing serve. He just basically hit it over the net. There was...
It's funny. It's Timo did this to him at the China Open when they played the final. When you realize your serves aren't working, sometimes just give him something different and simple. And a gift, omiyage. That's Japanese, by the way, for gift. What were you thinking?
I was thinking it's, again, he's going for the long, fast serve, which is, it's not something you would expect at this level. You'd expect more short serves. But as you say, he deceives the direction and the long, fast serve very well. And he does the counter topspin so well. So he invites the opponent to attack there, and then he plays the counter topspin.
One of the things that impresses me the most is, as we've mentioned, Lin Yun-Ju clearly not a big guy. Dima significantly, physically more, I'd say, imposing. But Lin Yun-Ru's base is so strong and he's so smooth. He's very stable. He recovers very quickly from his shots. This is interesting, sort of baiting him with the opening attack from the baseline of the table and then places it deep to the corner, testing the footwork on the backhand. Deja vu.
Amazing, we haven't seen the tomahawk serve, and yet they've clearly spoken about these tactics with Roscoff, and basically served every serve with the backhand, not put a lot of spin on it, not tried to disguise it too much, kept it fairly tight, and it's paying dividends. Clever tactics. Long push from Lin. Invited the topspin, then made the counter topspin. He does it so well.
Oh, what a backhand on the reach, full extension and hooking with side and topspin. Dima under pressure finds the corner of the table. This was very impressive. Again, with the opponent that far behind the table, rarely does someone take a chance to play to their forehand. This had all sorts of twists and turns in it, let alone the ball itself. So 2 points in front, Dima with the serves on his side.
Backhand topspin, this time from the backhand side of the table. Good use of elbow wrist.
It's a bit surprising here. Again, the serves look like there's not much on them, but I guess the contact is very subtle. A little bit more underspin than Lin Yun-Ju saw. Sort of a chop motion comes under the ball. Tough to tell how much he generated, which is part of the reason the receiver had the trouble. So I know we've got 2 game points for Dima here. I mentioned that Lin Yun-Ju is 4-2, but interestingly enough, despite the strong record, last time they played, it was Dima who won the match 4-1 at the Middle East Hub for WTT's contender. Beautiful backhand.
So relaxed, he gets the racket travelling very quickly, shoulder, elbow, wrist, and there, Ovtcharov, beaten by the pace.
Second game point for Dima on the receive. Oh, leaves the whole table open, throws all his chips in on the square. Absolutely going for the finisher, and Lin Yun-Ju gets the racket up high and blocks it back, but nobody's home. No alarm set, front door left wide open, security dog, nay.
But some people would have panicked there. They'd have seen the whole table wide open, but Lin Yun-Ju so calm. And three consecutive points.
Yeah, I like the way he took the pace off that one, invested in the spin shot, and left it a little bit lower and more shallow for Dima to make it uncomfortable to counter. Again, this match really could go either way. The first one will be a big, I'd say, momentum builder. confidence builder, game point for the silent assassin.
Spinny return from Ovtcharov, a lot of top spin.
Now, in case you're curious what they're doing, up, sweat squad. They're coming in. So smooth, almost as smooth as the forehand. The step around from the silent assassin. Sweat squad out. Tied up second deuce point, Dima with the serve. That's amazing. Backhand to forehand. Dima's backhand counter looping against Lin Yun-Ju's forehand, as smooth as that forehand is. Started with the forehands from Dima, and then he finishes with that last backhand. He's really developed the confidence and the consistency from behind the table with that backhand.
Quite a way back from the table as well.
Perfect placement, catches him in the crossover. Dima pinning up the silent assassin in the backhand corner, and 13-11, he takes game number one in this best of seven match. The winner will be leaving with a bronze medal, and the loser, well, will be leaving with a lot of motivation to come back at the next Olympic Games way stronger, because fourth place is maybe the toughest, as you mentioned, to go home with.
So the players now back to their respective corners. They have 1 minute. Rehydrate, take on board advice. And it is interesting in table tennis. By and large, you do have top quality ex-players in the corner. You look at some of the Chinese coaches, world champions, Olympic champions, the German coach there, Roscoff, as we mentioned, a world-class player, European champion.
I just have to speak to these replays. It's so amazing. Again, the amount of rotation generated on every shot in the rally. On the serve, you could see the toss right in near the body. Players getting as close to the body as they can get away with to keep things deceptive. And when you see a player breathe on the racket, when they blow on their hand, they're keeping their hand dry of sweat. When they breathe on the racket, they're cleaning the rubber for full traction. Good timing early off the bounce. One wide and then back to the backhand corner.
Using the whole table there, spraying the ball around the table.
So that was an example of Dima cleaning his rubber. You'll see it between points. Again, spin, absolutely crucial for control at this level. Good deception on the serve, I'd say. Maybe more side spin than anything else. I think Dima thought there was a bit of under on it and lifted.
He let it drop a little bit for me there. I thought take it a fraction earlier, but he obviously knows what he's doing. He was looking to spin the ball.
Hey, look what serve came out. The iconic tomahawk serve that he learned from his father, Mikhail, or Michael, depending on where you met him in his life. So changing it up instead of the simple backhand serves. Oh, beautiful backhand. The opening Chiquita countered back. Again, Dima yesterday played probably the best table tennis I've ever seen him play. And out here, he's just so quick to counter this topspin. In the replay they showed of that tomahawk serve, you could see how sharp of a turn it took on the second bounce, how much spin he generates.
Heavy backspin on the Lin service there. Came underneath the ball. Fast accelerating wrist. Generates the speed of the racket.
This ball is so tough to play. Slow, spinny, and low to the net. It's a handcuffing shot. Players get used to that fast pace of play. They step back for a moment when they see the player on the opposing side. Just drop the racket for the topspin. It's a nice rhythm breaker, and it's tough to counter.
Great counter topspin from Lin. Again, it was a fairly slow topspin from Ovtcharov.
How stable his legs look in that. I love looking at the quads of a player right before they hit. That's where the power comes from, off the ground, twisting at the waist as well.
Oh, yeah, come on!
Oh, that was quite some vocalization. I mean, I've heard Dima say Ale, I've heard a bunch of different things, but that sounded like two or three at once.
It's interesting, isn't it? The first game, he never used the tomahawk serve. Now every serve has been the tomahawk serve. Yeah. First game, served with his backhand. Didn't do a great deal with the serve other than keep it tight.
That said, he still managed to take game one. So much like the evolving sport of table tennis, I think it's going to be a game of catch me if you can. By the time you figure out my serve, it's like a burner cell phone. I'm going to leave it behind somewhere, move on to the next.
Ovtcharov's backhand going very well there, making the counter backhand top spins. Lin switched the play to the forehand, first few to the backhand. Ovtcharov copes really well with those. Then he just makes the error with that counter forehand top spin.
Yeah, Lin Yun-Ju clipped the top of the net on the last ball, which is part of the reason you see that finger of apology as opposed to the other one. Again, so much kick on that second bounce. The ball, like it has a mind of its own, just turning sharply. I'm curious what we're going to get third game from Dima service-wise. Maybe that low backhand where he's almost half under the table.
Again, the service is having trouble reading the spin. He came underneath it. Diddle in. Didn't read the spin. Ball popped up off his bat. And Ovtcharov in with a strong third ball attack. 6 points apiece.
That serve was quite effective against Ma Long yesterday. I felt like Dima earned a lot of, and again, you're not always looking for outright points at this level, more so setting up your third ball attack, just because it's so unlikely to fool someone badly enough to win the point outright on your serve. Unless, of course, you're Mima Ito. That's simply rude. Of course, it was unintentional, but what a heartbreaking point for Lin Yun-Ju. On top of it, smashes it almost out of the court completely, and it comes down on the edge. Dima, wow. When do you see Dima lobbing?
Again, that fast serve down the line. He did it twice. So unlucky to lose the point, but great retrieving by Ovtcharov.
Yeah, Lin Yun-Ju's bottle challenge serve, that one that goes right down the line but curves like it's going off the table but then comes back on. Explain the origin of that in a bit. Tied up 7 points apiece. Dima with the tomahawk.
Excellent return. Came across with the banana backhand. When you come across the table to play with your backhand from the forehand side, it's a natural to get more wrist into the shot from that position. Hence, a lot of the players are playing it now.
Dima trying to stay close to the table, blitz back in. You can feel the pressure as he starts to move into the table, but it puts more pressure on Dima as well because he has less time to react to this fast topspin shot.
I thought the key to the 2 points there was the return of service from Lin Yun-Ju. Outstanding. He attacked the return of serve and dominated the rally. 9-7, his two serves now. Oh, what a forehand topspin down the line. Anticipated it well, holds his ground. There he goes with the reverse backhand, and then what a shot, right in the corner of the table.
Side and topspin just bending away. Even making that ball would have been impressive, but the way he did it, quite devastating. Still a one-point lead for the silent assassin.
Oh, that was a big point as well. Two game points now for the silent assassin. He returned the serve quite superbly, the previous two that he had to receive.
So it's the opposite of the scoreline in game one. It was two game points at 10-8 at the third towel break for Dima. It worked out in his favor, despite Lin Yun-Ju getting the next 2 points. See if Lin Yun-Ju can capitalize here as he cleans off the rubber. Up, Sweat Squad! Too fast! No time for your theme song. Ooh. A bit surprising. He went back to the backhand serve that looks like a relatively nothing serve. Maybe that's exactly what it is, but plays it right at the baseline, keeps the banana flick off the aggressive. So one game point saved, one more for Lin Yun-Ju.
Backhand serve again.
Net for net, and Lin Yun-Ju escapes. 11-9, we are tied up one game apiece. The semifinals were spectacular. Tough matches to follow, but the two matches that we have today on the schedule could outdo them. This could go the distance. Again, it's a best of seven. We'll be back for game three. Chinese Taipei team's Lin Yun-Ju versus Germany's Dimitrij Ovtcharov right after this.
Start of the third game. Interesting tactically now. What serve are we going to see from Ovtcharov?
And it looks like the pendulum. Was just wondering if we'd get the pendulum serve.
He's so good with the backhand there. The pendulum serve, you worry a little bit for Ovtcharov that it will actually feed into the banana backhand of Lin Yun-Ju. Strong top spins from the 19-year-old from Chinese Taipei. Good start. He's now got his two serves to come.
Little fun fact. Born and raised in Ilan, a coastal, beautiful town in Taiwan. He's got his own training center there. It's really amazing to play in. Perfect placement, jams him in the middle with that forehand flick, too. I mean, we've seen it now on both wings. You and I have talked about how much of the table he can cover with that banana flick. You know, I've had the chance to play Lin Yun-Ju. He played the backhand around the net from the forehand side of the table against me. His backhand's been very strong on these higher balls, too. Dima's been spinning and arcing the ball a lot. It's very uncomfortable to play high backhands, but he gets that elbow up high and is still able to generate good counter topspins.
Wherever you put the ball to Lin Yun-Ju, he can topspin it with power at you, whether it's to his backhand, his forehand in the rally. Yes, that banana backhand on the return of service. He's got wonderful touch.
Another fun fact about the silent assassin. He plays quite well with his right hand.
We've had a few players who swap the hand round occasionally. We've not had anybody who comes out and plays the first game right-handed and the second game left-handed yet.
One with the foot, one with two rackets, one with the sword. No, I think Timo Boll probably the most famous for the hand switch, having done it against Ma Long and others. Koki Niwa does it quite well. But Lin Yun-Ju, I played a full game against his right hand. It's not easy. Actually hit a right-handed roller against me. I like it. Some vocalization there. I feel like it's part of a confidence thing with him. He's incredibly humble and low-key. But I feel like, for sake of being the best player he can be, he's starting to show a little bit, make eye contact with the opponent, connect with his coach.
Hey, come on!
Did well there. Ovtcharov to block that first ball back. Took Lin Yun-Ju by surprise. The surprise cost him the point. You mentioned that Lin Yun-Ju's father was a professor of leisure, as we would say. Leisure, I think, is how you say it.
Right, right.
But it's just so appropriate. His son is probably the most relaxed player in the table tennis tournament.
Yeah, his entire family is as chill as an ice cube. Oh, beautiful smooth stroke to clean up the back edge of the table. Serve just drifting off, taking a peek over the edge. What's over here? Lin Yun-Ju's racket, and I'm gone. Yeah, he really knows how to keep his cool. His favorite artist is Kygo, so he's always chilling. Baseline catches the edge. The apology from Dima. I think they've had a bit back and forth here. Some TTK, some table tennis karma. Goes around, comes around. Yeah, for me, that vocalization is part of the growth and confidence.
A good return from Ovtcharov. Good wristy backhand.
When we see Lin Yun-Ju counter in a lot of these, I'd say, rallies, he tends to be a little bit more forward-driven. That last one arced up, more of a counter spin shot from the backhand. If Sweat Squad is coming in right now, I couldn't even see him. They're like ninjas in the night. Again, one more.
Call them back.
Hey, why not? I always would. Sweat Squad. And they're gone. Just a flash. Okay, back for action with the dry table. Thank you, Sweat Squad. 7-4. And he follows it the whole way. That second shot from Lin Yun-Ju was very tough. It came back awkwardly to the middle of the table. Wasn't quite sure what to do, but got the racket up high and still put the pressure on.
There was a point, 2 or 3 points ago when exactly the same happened, and he didn't react in enough time to the Ovtcharov backhand, but then he was ready for it. As you say, he watched it very closely.
This footwork, Chiquita from wide on the forehand side and then all the way back to the opposite corner, still with the backhand. That's a real test in footwork. This is where the strength training and conditioning pays off. Good pressure from Dima, stepping around, keeps it low to the net and loaded with topspin.
You can see there, Ovtcharov just served a little bit wider out to the backhand. He was looking to play the reverse backhand, but he opted for the forehand as it was so wide, but played the forehand well. And then this time, Ovtcharov lifting what he thought was backspin. Good deception from Lin Yun-Ju. And so we have 5 game points.
Good attempt. Confidence on the forehand flick. Again, not easy to do. I don't think I've seen him miss a forehand flick yet this match. Good tight receive from Dima. How quickly he twiddles the racket there to clean both sides and get back and ready. Oh, and for a minute, he creeps in for a snack. He looks for that banana flick, but it's fast and long to the backhand side, and backpedaling still hits a winner. That's the power of the silent assassin. Guessed wrong, didn't matter. Right into the armpit of Dima. So it's a 2-1 lead in a best of 7. Dima has pulled off some heartbreaking for his opponent comebacks, but we'll see. A long way to go, and even yesterday against Ma Long, I mean, he just showed that he can turn it on late, that mentally, at 32 years old, he is very strong.
Again, it's 1 minute with their coaches, rehydrating. we'll be back to the table shortly. Just a few of the highlights. There was that smash that resulted in the edge ball from Ovtcharov. Interesting with Ovtcharov, tactically, with the serve. Serve, arguably the most important shot in the game. That's an interesting debate. But first game, all we did was the fairly straightforward backhand serve. Second game, he went for the tomahawk serve, and we saw one backhand serve. Third game, he varied his serves. We had a pendulum, we had a tomahawk. So where is he going to go in the fourth game? He's not settled, and maybe that's his tactics, to vary the service as we progress through the match.
Funny, someone asked me about Mima Ito's serves, the bronze medalist in women's singles who took down Yu Meng Yu of Singapore, who had an amazing tournament to be in the final four as the 26th seed. He said, do you think Mima Ito's changing her serves too much? Do you think it's helping her or not? And for me, I think it's just she's got the Chinese team constantly trying to capture her, take care of her. So when they figure out one serve, she has to make changes ever so slightly. I think for Dima, when someone has figured out his serve, he comes out with something else. Now that tomahawk serve, the first three times I tried receiving it, bottom of the net. I hit it into the bottom of the net. I'm like, okay, I get it. It's heavy underspin. Then I saw it again. I'm like, no, that's definitely not heavy underspin. It's straight side and bottom of the net. He's so deceptive with the wrist. And now he's back with a fresh shirt. But yeah, I am curious to see what he does service-wise here. And in terms of the potential debate that you brought up, you said would be interesting. Unfortunately, I can't make it very interesting for you. I don't think it's an interesting debate. I think the serve is the most important. I'm with you on that. It's the first shot. I mean, if people can't return your serve, it's over. Obviously, having a third ball, crucial, because you can't win points outright on serve so often here. But both of these players dangerous on the serve. So we'll see if the fresh shirt brings a fresh mentality. 2-1, Lin Yun-Ju with the serves. Just another example of how much side spin is on it. It touches the net and flies off the table to the side, spinning like a NASCAR tire. Ooh, omiyage. That's Japanese for gift. That was a gift for Dima to take home to Emma, his daughter.
Eddie, just a long, fast serve down the line, having just served off. It's so difficult to predict what Lin Yun-Ju is actually going to do.
Yeah, a lot of people be quite gun-shy after that, a bit hesitant to try. You just messed up doing it once. But as you said, fearless, bold. Going for broke, a very tricky shot from down low with so much topspin. If you've ever faced spin before, Dima hitting this much topspin at you, the ball wants to shoot up and hit the ceiling. So Lin Yun-Ju has to close the racket so much and try to stay on top of the ball.
Good, powerful topspins from Ovtcharov. Got him behind the serve with the backhand topspin, then good combination, switch to the forehand topspin. Good start by the German player, leads 3-1.
For me, this was a nice change of pace. Lin Yun-Ju slowing it down, blocking it with less rotation so that the ball's left out in front. Dima way behind the table. No need to try and overpower it. Just plays it softly to get himself back in position and leave an awkward ball. So 1 point between them now. Second serve here for Lin Yun-Ju.
Great return of serve. Good touch, good feel there to return that ball tight. I just thought in the first game, Ovtcharov won the first game, his backhand was tremendous. He just played powerful top spins from quite a distance from the table and never missed.
Let's face it, Dima's got one of the best backhands in the world. It's a cannon. It's the reason Zhang Jike had his first loss at a World Championships in 2014. There it is, comes out. Just right as it was called, it was like the bat signal for the backhand. The backhand signal was shot into the sky. Maybe he's listening to commentary like you. After all, he does know it's a key ingredient to his victories. So service-wise, he's mixing it up a bit. We've got a few of those iconic serves, the tomahawk, the backhand, where most of his body's under the table, just the chin above.
Lin Yun-Ju virtually always serves with his forehand from the backhand side, but he's constantly varying the service. Down the line, on the diagonal, short, short with backspin, short with no spin.
Yeah, in general with the service, until someone gives him a reason not to, I mean, he's going to stick with it because it's working. If you can create that much variety from one place on the table, by all means. Seemed like the serve got away from Dima. The rhythm of the bounce is there. From this camera angle, it's not always so clear how high the ball's sitting, but the timing. So much of table tennis is audible. Top edge of the racket for Lin Yun-Ju after some strong backhands. Look at the scoreboard here. What are you thinking right now? Still thinking?
I'm still thinking.
Yeah,
it's an interesting game tactically. You know, from the service onwards, it's a very interesting game. I think Ovtcharov has the potential to win this. He's just got to put the strong topspins together. He did it in the first game with his backhands and forehands. He's 9-4 up, 9-3. That was a let serve, of course. So, you know, we had Lin winning the third game 11-6 fairly convincingly, and now we've got Ovtcharov winning the fourth game with 7 game points coming up. So, a very interesting bronze medal match. I'm not sure who's going to win this one. I've 50-50.
Yeah, sounds fair to me. The bottle challenge serve. Again, the name comes from ITTF had a challenge that went viral online where you put a water bottle or any sort of liquid bottle near the edge of a table and serve around it. That's the shape of that serve from Lin Yun-Ju. Still 6 game points for Dima. And that's all he needs. 11-4 domination here to come into game number 5 with some serious momentum and a level playing field. No tilting. It is an even battle, and that 50-50 continues. It's going to be a suspenseful one down to the very wire. Will we have a match as good as the semifinals yesterday? Well, it's quite possible. Stay right here to find out.
So, Ovtcharov jogging back out to the table. Lin Yun-Ju using the full 1 minute before he's called back by the umpire. So, the Ovtcharov serve, what are we going to see? We know what we're going to see from Lin Yun-Ju, although having said that, he varies it immensely, but he does serve from the same position nearly every serve. But he can vary the spin, vary the direction, vary the length. Very difficult to pick up what he's actually going to do with the service, Lin, to spot it.
Ooh, it was called fault. Interesting, interesting. I love a bit of drama.
But no warning.
Exactly.
Normally they get a warning. So that means it must, in the umpire's opinion, it was a fairly serious fault, otherwise he would have warned him.
The question is, what was it? We couldn't see the umpire. Was it dropping below the table? For me, this has been something, you know, I've been watching 7 years religiously on the world tour, and the ball dips below the table in his hand sometimes, but there are a lot of little things that players don't get called on in a normal tournament. But at the Olympics, the rules are enforced more strictly than anywhere else. And you're right, they do normally get a warning, but it's not required.
Oh, that long fast serve down the line. We saw Marlong yesterday foul serve for spinning the ball as he threw the ball up, imparting spin.
Right.
Don't see that very often.
Yeah, not at the professional. It's not so common, at least on the world tour. Interestingly enough, he was warned for something else. Blocking with his head. Perfect placement into the middle, following his serve in near the table. It's Lin Yun-Ju collecting his 4th point. It's funny, in terms of families and how these players get into table tennis, both of Dima's parents were table tennis coaches. No one in Lin Yun-Ju's family plays seriously.
Oh, great shot there. Counter topspin, step round the back, and he anticipated the ball coming on the diagonal. Took a little bit of a chance, went early, but excellent tactics.
Oh, through the barriers, please show us a replay of that. He already almost hit Dima out of the corner. This one's just a little bit shallow. Good cover in the middle, then the block to create the opening. Up on 1 foot, catches it on the rise. There it is. Just getting some branding for the Olympics Tokyo 2020, a reminder of where we're at and where Dima's right foot is specifically. A lot of fun stories about breaking barriers over the years, huh? Placement from Dima, jamming up Lin Yun-Ju. He felt like he only had one chance here. He's already leaning, says if I can get the forehand up and play it wide enough, it's probably not coming back. That barrier breaking, by the way, wasn't a metaphor. Literally barriers creating worldwide news, but also metaphorically speaking. Tough to lob to Lin Yun-Ju. Just amazing how early and how much power. Again, you look at this guy, you don't think power. You're like, well, he must be fast. But he can't lob to him right now. That ball's just shallow on the table, though. Whenever someone's lobbing, they have to keep it right near the baseline with heavy topspin so it kicks away.
Oh, pace. Oh, my goodness. The backhand topspin, the four, both off the bounce. That is absolutely top-class table tennis.
This is absolutely why you want a table tennis player as your designated driver. The reaction time is just unbelievable.
Perfect placement there, down the middle. Ovtcharov wasn't sure whether to play a backhand or a forehand. Got himself in a little bit of a tangle. 8-2. It's amazing how the game can change. 11-4 the last game in favor of Ovtcharov, and now 8-2 in the lead for the Chinese Taipei player. Oh. Did that touch? It went that fast. I know it did touch, but it was difficult to spot. Just watch this again. Bearing in mind this is slow motion. Long fast serve again. Good placement into the body. Right into that very awkward spot underneath the playing arm, the elbow.
Not too common to see a second towel break with a scoreline like this. And as you mentioned, coming off of an 11-4 loss for Lin Yun-Ju. With this pattern, Dima should win next game 11-0, and then we'll be in the seventh. So one game point saved. Seen some massive comebacks throughout the Olympic Games, so you can never be sure.
Oh, well played. You do wonder, Ovtcharov's such a good player, I'm sure he wouldn't let it affect him, but you do just wonder if he got annoyed at being foul-served at Laval without a warning. Went 1-0 down, and all of a sudden, you know, he's 10-2 down.
Right, that's a good point. It is tough to just shrug it off. Fast wing there, gets the racket up on the forehand from the middle, and 11-4, a favor returned. He re-gifted the scoreboard to Dima, and it is a 3-2 lead. For Lin Yun-Ju, the silent assassin, he's one game away from getting his second medal to bring back home to the beautiful island. And we shall see as the match continues. Dima's been a bit of a comeback artist, so it is far from over. Again, first player to win 4 games to 11 points, must win each game by at least 2.
There we have the story of this bronze medal match so far.
You know, they say about Dima that he is the hardest working player. There are players on the German team, Ricardo Walter namely, that just have incredible feeling. And for Dima, it's not a hand thing, it's a work ethic thing. From a young age, his father told him, you need to work as hard as you can today so that you can succeed tomorrow. Leave no regrets, do your best. And he's kept that attitude. Now, interestingly enough, Dima, as you mentioned, 2017, took four titles and the Men's World Cup. Two platinum events, two World Tour events, and still was actually not voted ITTF Male Star because Timo Boll had this comeback against Lin Gaoyuan and Ma Long in the Men's World Cup and just captured the hearts of fans around the world. But Dimas played some incredible table tennis, and this tournament is some of the best.
The backhand from the forehand side. Well, probably more the middle of the table there, but nevertheless, still coming across the table, playing that reverse banana backhand.
This time the opening backhand goes the way of Dima, really makes that first ball count, and it's tough to counter. Positioning, the placement here, not just pace, we've seen the speed come right back at him.
Again, this time right round on the backhand side, on the forehand side, playing the backhand. There he goes.
I wouldn't be surprised if we see Dima go back to some of those emptier serves from the backhand.
Chong Pan Lung on his feet.
Quite frankly, I think a big part of it is Lin Yun-Ju comes in prepared. Thank you, Sweat Squad. The check is in the mail. But yeah, all these serves you can study on YouTube. You can see these players. Good pressure into the middle, bringing him over to the center of the table and hitting the elbow. Dima ties it up. Again, Dima has his back against the ropes now. He must win this game to take it to a seventh. If he doesn't win, it's over.
Good camera angle there to see the loose grip.
Very cautious and calculated play. He chases down the first forehand and on the run is able to loop it back and arc it up over the net. Wasn't in perfect position for the next ball, so he played it a little bit more cautiously. Again, a secure looping shot with that topspin.
Both players there, but it was Ovtcharov who held his ground, sprayed the ball around the table, played with spin, actually hit a few quite hard. That more of a drive than the spin with the forehand, and that's the one that won the point.
It's funny, thinking back to Lin Yun-Ju's game, there was a time where he beat Dima so steadily. I talked to Rossi, and Rossi just sort of shrugged his shoulders and said, "This kid, we had no chance." But not the same story here today. This hasn't worked out so well for Lin Yun-Ju. Dima's been very effective. It's spinning it low and deep to the backhand corner while staying in position to cover the cross-court forehand, which tempts Lin Yun-Ju to play the short side, but it's just a low percentage shot.
Lin Yun-Ju, they're just playing to the middle, playing. Never once did he play the same ball to the same place. All the time moving it there. That's the middle and wide to the forehand.
There's a different determination in the eyes of Lin Yun-Ju than I've seen before. And you can hear him too. You know, both of these players I mentioned this tournament are playing outstandingly well. Lin Yun-Ju rose to fame after beating Ma Long, beating Fan Zhendong, and he's beaten Ma Long several times now. But in the last year and a half, I'd say a bit of a quiet sort of set of results from Lin Yun-Ju.
So timeout has been called by Germany. Sensing a little bit of momentum being built by Lin Yun-Ju. Chance to retalk the tactics.
Now, you've been in the coach's corner. You were at three Olympic Games as the coach for England. What would you be telling your player right now?
I mean, he's playing Lin Yun-Ju. Lin Yun-Ju is possibly one of the best young players I've seen. You know, he can do everything. And I agree with what Roscoff said to you, that this kid is just brilliant. But I think what I'd be saying is that Ovtcharov's got to try and impose himself on Lin Yun-Ju. He can't afford to place a positive return of service, try and take the initiative, move the ball around the table, maybe the other one wide to the forehand because he's coming around and playing a lot of backhands from the forehand side. I think being positive is the key message here. He's got to take the initiative. He's got to get on top in the rally. It's been a fascinating match.
Well, I expect more of the same here on out. Back from the timeout, Dima in red for Germany on the receive. Ooh, this one could have gone either way. I think Dima celebrating there, knowing that it was just this close to hitting the back of the table and right out of the timeout. A bit of fuel in the tank. Ties it up at 5 points apiece.
And it's the tomahawk. The angle wide to the backhand was extraordinary.
Yeah, I was just thinking, what a wide shot to play.
Did he kick the side spin he got?
He was relatively middle on the table, too, to find that placement on the table. Really impressive. And then into the middle to jam him for the point.
Oh, that is wonderful stuff by both players. But Ovtcharov really is looking to be aggressive.
Yeah, this is crazy for me. As fast as Lin Yun-Ju opens here, Dima doesn't let up for a second. Pedal to the metal, full speed ahead in the backhand, even out of reach. The wide wing just rips it back. So second towel break, dead even again. Dima can't afford to lose another game.
Positive return of serve required by the German player. Difficult to know what serve he's going to receive.
Ooh, break off the net, Lin Yun-Ju. Getting the top of the net and completely keeping the ball short inside the table.
Interesting here that Ovtcharov looked to actually do something. He could have got that back on the table, but he knew he had to keep it tight. Looking to play a soft return. Keep the ball over the table.
That place has been the jackpot for Dima. I mean, how many times can you think about it where he's just spun the ball really deep to that backhand corner? And a big part of it is he's in position. Lin Yun-Ju trying to play a little bit more middle of the table to avoid the counter forehand.
Again, that little soft serve. Not a lot going on there, but he brings it in every now and again. And it seems to be effective.
You can't say soft serve to me right now because you know I love ice cream. Back with the backhand. Dima up by one.
And then he really bit into that with the bat.
Stop it. Enough with the biting and all these eating references. Soft serve, come on.
The ball was fizzing with spin.
And carbonation. 2 points down. Quite a shift in momentum here. Just a seesaw. Again, the plot twists throughout. Dima gets 1 point, then he'll have the serves back on his side with 2 game points to send this to the decider. That's Lin Yun-Ju from the shoes up. Started for the bottom. Now he's here. Wow. Well, he had an answer this time. A very well-calibrated closed racket to keep the ball down on this counter. And from here, he's in control. Dima still dangerous with that backhand, just catching the white at the top of the net. If that goes just about a centimeter higher, that's a winner down the line.
That was very close to being an unbelievable shot from Ovtcharov. Good gutsy play from the German player. So now 9 points apiece. 2 points away from a bronze medal in the men's singles, Lin Yun-Ju. Oh, bronze medal point coming up.
This is just so quick. Stay focused, you got this, Chang Peng Long says. Be in the point, be in the game. Every point, Dima's had some massive comebacks before. Saved a few match points in the semifinals against Ma Long, the defending gold medalist, sweat squad. See you soon. And as he cleans the racket, again, bronze medal point for the silent assassin. Ooh, saved. Dima still here. Deuce in game number six. So now we'll be alternating serves. Again, in the 11-point game since about the year 2000, right after the Olympics, it's been an 11-point game, alternating serves every 2 points. But at deuce, 10-10, every point they will switch serves. Ooh, heavy underspin on the pendulum. Some deception here.
Second bronze medal point.
And he called the timeout. Lin Yun-Ju. The timeout on the other side had already been called, so conversation in the corner with Zhang Peng Long.
Ovtcharov has the serve.
Interesting.
What's he going to do? Pendulum. Tomahawk. Backhand.
But which backhand, though? I'm wondering which backhand he's going to serve.
So again, wonderful entertainment.
It's funny, Dima has some of the most iconic serves in table tennis. Even in silhouette, you could pick him out, just be like, Dima. Very unusual serves, most of which he's learned from his father. The only person quieter than the silent assassin is physiotherapist who is sitting behind Zhang Peng Long.
Zhang Peng Long, though, was very calm. I thought that was, you know, really good.
Yeah.
Kept his, I mean, he's super calm anyway, but.
I think he was getting on Lin Yun-Ju's level. Ooh,
again, backhanded, have a chance to make it. A wry smile on the face of the teenager from Chinese Taipei.
So the timeout has been defused. Second deuce. Serve with Lin Yun-Ju.
Third bronze medal point. Third time lucky. Let's wait and see.
The counter backhand, a bold attempt, jumping to finish. Dima gets the first tough one back. ITTF president, excuse me, CEO, Steve Dayton, Zoran Primorac there as well. ITTF Athletes Commission, basically the VIPs of the table tennis world watching closely. That would have been a crazy way to finish it. A mid-air jumping backhand in response to the Dima rocket. Third deuce point. Oh, no chance! That first ball, the forehand, had so much side spin. He slowed it down because he saw Dima was on the ground. This is some high IQ table tennis. Look how much kick there was in the backhand to the exact corner where the white lines meet. Talk about flirting with disaster. This ball was dangerously close, and look at that eye contact. Man! It's just amazing how much tension these players can handle. Dima still in it, saves another match point.
That's four match points he saved.
Beautiful touch shot here. Dima slows it down. A very awkward ball with a bit of side spin on it as well to break the rhythm. Watch the way it bounces. Plays it softly from under the table, straightens out to the forehand a bit and causes some trouble. So game point to Dima. And we are going to the decider. So grab your snacks, grab your healthy beverages, and tell your friends exactly what they need to be watching right now. The men's singles bronze medal match of Tokyo 2020, Game 7, the decider, coming right up.
So the last time that the players will come back to the corner for advice anyway.
I've got a question for you. You just lost four match points. confidence-wise, how do you regain your composure if you're Lin Yun-Ju?
I think he has it all. And I think he's mentally tough, and that's what you need here. You need mental toughness. You need somebody who now forgets about that. You can't dwell on that. You can't do anything about what's happened in the past. You focus on what can happen in the future. And I'm pretty sure that's what Lin Yun-Ju will do. And, of course, Ovtcharov is just a fighting machine. He's going to fight for every point.
In terms of mental maturity, I think you're absolutely right, and having Professor Chill as your father doesn't hurt either.
Good start by the German player. He won the bronze medal in London, and I'm pretty sure that he beat a player from Chinese Taipei.
Well, it would have been Zhuang Zhiyuan if it was anyone. Good kick serve here.
He's here. He's here playing in the tournament, isn't he?
Zhuang Zhiyuan. Oh, yeah. He had an incredible tournament.
He finished fourth. Chinese Taipei finished fourth in London. And
third would be much preferred.
Players will change ends at 5 points. Psychological advantage to change ends with a lead. A couple of points lead would be very nice for either player.
That's a big point.
And it's that surprising serve where he just simply just didn't do a lot with it. Now he's lining up for the tomahawk. Forehand serve with heavy spin.
Good placement into the middle. As a taller player, Dima's got a bigger middle to cover and is going to use the backhand more. But the perfect placement, Lin Yun-Ju, just on the forehand side of the elbow, tempts Dima to turn and take out that forehand. Lin Yun-Ju played his only Olympic appearance was the Youth Olympic Games. And he got fourth place there, the bronze medal match. It was Kunikja of USA who took the bronze medal over Lin Yun-Ju in a nail-biting seven-gamer.
Great counter top spin from Ovtcharov. Second serve in this sequence of two coming up. Big point. Don't want to change ends at 5-3 down.
What an angle here. Dima going way wide out to the forehand, testing the footwork of Lin Yun-Ju. We've seen both players now playing shots that are incredibly high risk and under pressure, just pulling them off. It's Chong Peng Long in the corner. Hao. Let's go, you got this.
Good.
Clever idea.
But powerful shots from Ovtcharov there. He was away from the table. He played a strong forehand, then a strong backhand. And the power was just a little bit too much.
That was Lily Zhang and Sun Ying Sha there in the crowd, the VIPs.
I'm pretty sure that this could still twist and turn. 7-3, Ovtcharov looking good, but you cannot write off Lin Yun-Ju. Oh, the net cord helped the returner serve. And now, having saved 4 bronze medal points, Dimitrij Ovtcharov leads by 8 points to 3.
Well, now this is starting to look more and more encouraging for the man who saved all those match points, those bronze medal points at the second towel break. Dimitrij Ovtcharov just 2 points away from securing his second bronze medal 9 years later. In table tennis, that's pretty crazy. There's a relatively short lifespan for players. Of course, you've got Zhuang Zhiyuan, Timo Boll, and a few others that play a long time. Good backhand, keeping Dima behind the table. Now, as attractive as it looks to watch as a spectator when someone gets way behind the table, it's a massive disadvantage to be that far behind the table. Too much ground to cover, not as much element of surprise or threat time-wise. Too much time for the opponent to react. Still a 5-point lead. Second serve here could be crucial for Dima. And the good Chiquita, strong opening.
So, Lin Yun-Ju now with his two serves. If he can take these 2 points, what a lifeline that would be.
We've seen a lot of twists and turns already.
Oh my. He's coming back.
Wow, man. I've got space for somebody else on the back of my seat right now. Extra spin there, but still so fast. A little bit more shallow. Good drive. No timeouts left. Sweat squad, sweat squad. What you gonna do? You're gonna get ready to play because they're gonna dry the table for you. Six serving nine, second serve here with the silent assassin. Oh, it's out of reach. This is the second time at the business end of a match that we've seen Dima hesitate. And maybe just the shot was too good. If it's quick off the... Oh, he was clenching his fist. He was chilling.
He thought he'd won the point. He thought that was going off the end of the table.
Premature chole. Oh, party foul.
Oh, there it is. That long, fast push deep into the backhand forces the error. And three bronze medal points now for Germany.
Off the top of the net, Dima does it. He takes his second bronze medal, and this time over the silent assassin. He cannot believe it. His head in his hands, and Germany with a bronze medal 9 years after the fact. He apologized. He said sorry for the net. But the hard work from the time he was a child to being a proud father, a son to his father, the table tennis champion, Dimitrij Ovtcharov, brings Germany another medal. A moment of joy, all the hard work, the ups and downs. He was injured just a week, 2 weeks ago in the European preparations and comes out here and gets revenge on a player who had 4-2 and had 4 bronze medal points. What a dramatic comeback and finish for Germany's Dima Dimitrij Ovtcharov.
Clearly a very close relationship between Roscoff and Ovtcharov. Delight in the German corner, disappointment in the Chinese Taipei corner. But a second bronze medal in men's singles, London and now Tokyo.
That is hello and welcome to the victory ceremony. You're watching Tokyo 20. It's been the wonderful world of table tennis. And the best players in the world just battled for the medals. But from the semifinals on, there is no question. We got every single cent we spent to enjoy the thrills, spills, turns and twists of this event, the men's singles. So as the medalists come out, in the front you see Fan Zhendong, following behind him Ma Long, and behind him Dimitrij Ovtcharov. Dima and just like in the women's battle, you wish that you could give out 4 medals because everyone played so well. From the semifinals on, there is no question that this was an epic men's singles event at Tokyo 2020. And while he will not be here, a shout out to Lin Yun-Ju Search him on YouTube. He's incredible. But these three were the best in the men's singles event, and we will start off by honoring our second-time bronze medalist from Germany.
The medals will be presented by...
Medal の贈呈は...
Madame Sarah Walker, membre du CIO Nouvelle-Zélande, Olympienne, une médaille d'argent.
So on the right, we have Mrs. Sarah Walker, IOC member, a Kiwi from New Zealand. An Olympian took a silver medal. Interestingly enough, gets to wear a gold medal right now. That's pretty cool.
Madame Petra Sorling, vice-présidente de la Fédération Internationale de...
And the ITTF Executive Vice President from Sweden, Mrs. Petra Sorling. I've had a chance to play table tennis with her, actually. She's been a strong advocate and a hard worker to develop the sport over the last, long before I was involved at this level. So a long time, a lovely person, and a deep, passionate heart for table tennis. She's still playing, actually, which is quite exciting.
Dimitrij Ovtcharov.
And our bronze medalist playing the best table tennis I've seen from him in his life, Dimitrij Ovtcharov, Dima of Germany, once again. An Olympic bronze medal bringing pride to Deutschland. Ich liebe Tischtennis. I love table tennis. There is no question that Dima carries on a family tradition. Both of his parents coaches. Must be incredibly proud. And interestingly enough, a father to Emma, him and Jenny Ovtcharov, both table tennis players. And a very proud moment for the Ovtcharov family. The hard work has paid off through injury, through thick and thin. He stands here today.
Silver medalist, People's Republic of China.
銀メダリスト、中華人民共和国。
Fan Zhendong.
And our silver medalist, world number one, Xiaopeng, little fatty, Fan Zhendong. Fan Zhendong has been incredible for the last several years and holds up his silver medal with pride. As dominant as he's been in the game, there's only one player who could stop him here. He's got an incredibly bright future ahead, and I would not be surprised to see him with a gold medal around his neck 3 years from now. But a wizard on the table, a brain like no other. The man, the captain, the dragon, the dictator. With love, will stand in front of the world. On the top podium, here he is, two-time Olympic gold medalist, a world record. Never has it been done before, the greatest of all time. Ma Long proudly wears the gold medal for the second time in his career and for the first time in history. We have witnessed a raising of the bar at the Olympic Games. This will not happen for a long time. Maybe in your lifetime you will see it, but a record that will be very difficult to break. Ma Long, the three-time and defending world champion, three consecutive time, has two consecutive gold medals, and now the most famous national anthem in table tennis. No matter where you are, please stand for the Chinese national anthem.
People's Republic of China.
皆様、中華人民共和国。国歌の演奏です。
Mesdames et messieurs, les médaillés olympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
皆様, Olympic.
So what a crowd there on screen. Again, the Chinese national team, the superstars of the sport, and the masks are off, the smiles are out. I think Fang Zhendong's might not be the smile that you would hope to see, and a very humble smile from Ma Long, taking it easy. Wow, so much charm. And you don't get to see that face. Again, it's the Mamba mentality. So many athletes have inspired Ma Long, and he will inspire countless athletes for decades to come. From YouTube videos to television shows, the table tennis spectacle that he's brought to the sport, we can only hope and cherish the moments that we have. Jorg Roscoff with the thumbs up. And Timo Boll, for the last two decades, has been one of the few to challenge the Chinese. But here at the Olympic Games, the tournament that Dima has been able to deliver in 2012, and now again in 2021 at Tokyo 2020, they wear their flags proudly on their face and bring medals home to their nations. Two of the biggest table tennis nations in the world. Liu Guoliang with two thumbs up. Qin Zhijian behind him just the same. Li Sun, He Xiao. Wang Manyu behind, along with Olympic gold medalist Chun Meng, who last night left a giant footprint in history, but no footprint as big as the one Ma Long has created for China here at Tokyo 2020. Table tennis, a year-round sport. If you're just getting into it now, welcome to the wonderful world of table tennis. It's magical year-round. You don't want to miss it. So be sure to follow all the table tennis you can on the internet, on TV. Will this man get a fourth world championship title as well in Houston in November? I don't know, but what I do know is right now, there is no question that Ma Long is the greatest table tennis player there ever was. While he stands tall and proud, he kisses the gold medal. He said before this tournament started, if he loses a single game, he will have let down China. And he hasn't dropped a single match. Everything has been won. Undefeated. Once again, just like in Rio 2016, which gave the nickname to his son, Mario. Fans nicknaming his son after